Hello, it's Sara. I've decided to film this art journal page today. I'm going to do the butterflies. These are the butterflies. These are my Stampendous stamp. These are called pen pattern butterflies. It's a big, big butterfly. So I've just cut them out of book pages, stamped them out, and then cut around it. And I'm going to glue those into the page. But first, I want to do a background. And I'm just going to go with my go-to colors. I have a palette that I really enjoy. So these are like my go-tos. Blue and yellow make green. Pink and yellow make orange. Purple. I don't know. So I don't get mud too often. I also like to, I'm not sure if I'll throw some orange in. I have my gold. I love my metallics. But these, none of these are the pearls. I've been using the Martha Stewart pearl paints, but today I want to use my Twinkling H2Os. I just got these, so I don't know what they're going to do, but this is going to be what I'm going to have that's sparkly. So my background will be kind of flat. So let's go ahead and start. And I am going to do these in washes. I call them washes. So basically that's, this is just a regular acrylic paint. I'm a bottle baby. We call ourselves bottle babies. But when I learned to paint, I didn't do mixing. I didn't learn to mix. And so I'm a bottle baby. I just grab the color I want out of the bottle. And, you know, the paint companies love us because we buy lots of paint. Because real painters only need, I think it's like 6 or 7 colors. And you can make every color you want. Oh, I have my paper palette over here. I've been using my craft mat. So those of you who have a craft mat, just use that. I do side loading with my brush. I'm using a really big, this is a probably like a 1-inch angle. Oh, it says 3/4 inch, so it's not a 1-inch. And I have lots of water in my brush, and I'm just gonna corner load it. So I just put the corner of the brush in paint. And I go to my paper palette over here and kind of just blend the paint into the brush. It's overly wet, though. I am absolutely going for that because I don't want my page to be opaque. And I may even add more water to this to get it even thinner than that. I think I am. So this coat is just water now. I only have water on my brush. And I'm kind of pulling that paint I just put down and watering it down even more. I just don't like that I lose the background. I don't want to lose the background. That's the whole point of, I mean, the like the Tim Holtz paper. I don't want to lose it. So I like to, like I'll go over this butterfly though pretty heavily. How about that? Like I'll, and then I'll start to bleed it out. But I've gessoed, so first thing I did was put that Tim Holtz paper down with my matte medium. I have a liquid matte medium. Here it is, Liquitex matte medium. This is the fluid. It's a very fluid glue. My battery's blinking. Shocker. I'm going to put a little yellow now. See what happens there. Look, this is just getting color down because the sky has a lot. This is, yeah, I'm not going to even try it, but I'm trying to, you know, be very artistic and tell you why there's a lot of colors. Really, the reason is because I like it. That's all I need to know. But if you look at real paintings, like say real paintings by real artists, They put a lot of color back there because this is a background. It's not the main picture. I'm going to do stamping on top of this. All types of stuff. All kinds of stuff. Anything fun. That's what I like to do. So let's see. I'm going to add more blue over in this corner. Pick up my page a little bit. So yesterday, this is Monday, we did end up painting James's room. And it's beautiful because it was disgusting. Boy, teenage boys really are gross. I love you, James. He'll never watch this. But, yeah, I mean, we got to clean that carpet, too. Oof. But, it looks so fresh and happy again. And my cousin Fran is coming for a visit, so that's where she's going to be able to stay and have her own space. You guys, do you ever clean your houses anymore? Seriously, like, you know, it really, like, I could be mopping a floor right now. I really, really could be. But I'm not. I'm sitting here doing this. It's a lot more fun than mopping a floor. That's for sure. So I just wanted to bring some yellow down there. So that's looking pretty, right? I think I need more yellow over here. And it actually turns a little greenish when I put it with the blue. But I like that. I think I'm going to stop. Like, that's good. I want to stop. I'll dry it and I'll be right back. Okay, so I was going to add more blue up here, but then I thought, no, I'm not done painting. I'm going to use my stencils with paint. I picked out three different ones that I'm going to use. The blue is going to be the swirls, so I'm going to stencil some blue swirls, the same color, I just used. I'll do the pink with this flower background. It's like a floral, and these are all different kinds of stencils. This one's old as can be. I don't even know. This one looks like a Diane Reeve or one of the Ranger artists. And I think this is Stamper's Companion Workshop. I forget. All right. I'm not good with my supply list, guys. If you guys, you know, listen, this is all what you have. Use what you have. Because that's what I'm doing. I have this one. This is a Workshop one, I think, but I'm gonna do this with gold. So that's the only thing I'm gonna bling up my background with. So let's get started. I have this. This is that cut and dry foam pads. This is by Ink Centrals, but I think Ranger makes it too. And I've just been reusing these. They're getting a little hard, but I've been cleaning them off. I'm gonna go with my blue first. So let's do some swirls. And I'm gonna put it, since I didn't have blue up in this area, I'm going to put some blue swirls up here. So I just take my foam pad and go right into the paint like this. I think I'm going to need more. And then I just kind of pounce it on top of these swirls. And whatever happens, happens. I'm not going for real definition or, you know, I just want it to be a little extra something. See, it bled through, but I don't care because we're going to put a lot of other stuff on top of this. So I need a little more blue paint. One of my butterflies could be sitting right there eventually. So maybe, I don't know. I'm trying to be more, maybe I need less paint on the sponge too. So that it doesn't bleed under, Velocity Vet 08, I think it is. She had these cool brushes that she was stenciling through, but I don't have the patience. Like, I just really want to get it on there. But the way it looks after, you know, I mean, that's the difference. If you're going for, I think she was making a card anyway, so that would have been like a more focal design that she was looking for. And that, in that case, it's worth it. But for me, this is just a little added texture too, because this stencil definitely makes it a little more textural, but the way the paint is going on, it's like bumpy, spongy. All right, so that could be all I need for blue. I think a little bit right here. That looks good enough. All right, so I'm going to set that aside and go in with, I should probably dry it. I'm sorry, I'm going to dry because that was my label maker because it's plugged in. I should unplug it. I just don't want everything to get all muddy if I keep adding paint. So the next color I'll do is some pink flowers. I'm going to put pink flowers up in this corner. And again, just using an old one of these sponges that I've been using. Actually, the same sponge. And let's see how this stencil behaves. Cool, I like it. That's all I want to do is just like it. I don't want it to be. Okay. And it's just adding subtle, some more pink, which I think I'm going to put right here too, because there isn't any pink here. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Sort of, kind of, huh? I really want to change my camera setup, but I don't really know what to do. I want to put it over my head in some way. See, there's already pink up there, but I'm going to put one little speck of it down here. I like that I can move it because it's on a tripod, my camera, but I think having it overhead would just be out of my way, and I gotta put like something right here. I like doing that too, that technique, just really. So all right, so that's that. I gotta dry it, sorry. Real time. I could go away and come back when I'm dry. The next thing I'm gonna do is some yellow. And I think it's still not, I mean, it's getting darker, obviously it is. So I don't know. I mean, I like it though, but hopefully the butterflies are still gonna be the most visible thing. You know, they're the stars of the show, so I want them to be popping. Want them to be popping. All right, so I'll use this one. I'm gonna do some yellow circles. I love these circles. They're easy to do. And this yellow, I pulled the CAD yellow. I didn't mention that before, but I've been using like straw, which is a more like brown yellow. This one's a more vibrant yellow. And so that's what I'm using. And this one I'm just gonna like kind of do like that. It's way faster. See how fast that was? Put some over here. I'm a faster. I like things to go down quick. Look at that. Oh, wow. It's so pretty. I love these colors. They just make me happy. All right, look, guys. A little bit right here. Just a tiny bit. And it kind of went green, but I like it. All right, so look. Good. I think there's a lot of yellow right here, but that's okay. Maybe I'll put some gold there. What should I put? Blue? No, I'm gonna leave it. It is what it is. All right, good. Next thing I wanted to do was some of these, and I'm not sure how these will turn out because it might just make the background. Kind of like it. I'm gonna do the dragonflies. I'm gonna do this and this, just a couple of them. That's it. That's all I'm gonna do. Let me dry these yellow dots and just add a couple of dragonflies. But isn't that pretty? Like, see, that's pretty to me. That's all I need to make me happy. All right, next I'm gonna do these, and I'm just gonna use my gold metallic paint, and I think I'm gonna rub it on like I just did with the other sponge. I'm gonna just kind of see what happens when I do that. This dragonfly is gonna be right here. Hopefully it'll not go under too much. It'll just stay. Yay, look, I'll show you in a minute. I'm gonna put another one down here. You can totally tell. Maybe it's a good quality stencil too. Oh yes, you can totally see that. Oh, I love it. All right, I'm gonna put a couple more of this guy. Put this little one right here, and I'll probably cover them up with my big butterflies, but you know what? It's all right. I love them. They are adorable. Oh wow, that was the best idea I've had in a long time. All right, I'm gonna keep this here, but I'm gonna pull this. Look, I mean, my lighting is not the greatest, but you can totally see. There he is, look. Oh, there he is, and here's another one. Yay, okay, that worked, success. And now I gotta do a little bit of stamping. I don't know, huh? I don't want to get carried away because I kind of really like this background. Maybe I should stamp after I've adhered. I think that was 10 minutes already. Let me see. Yeah, my battery looks fine. So next step I would normally do is some stamping. And I've been thinking about it, and I don't want to overwhelm the page, but I will be doing some stamping. I am going to go with a couple different things. I think I'm gonna do some blue. I wanna get some more archival paints in the colors, but for now I have the stays on in these two colors. But I think I'm gonna do some of this teal blue. Gonna do some circles with the teal blue, and I think this is a Tim Holtz stencil. I also really love this stencil, stamp. This is Dina Wakely again, or let me make sure, because I always say it wrong. Diane Reevely, not Dina Wakely. I get them both mixed up. But I've had these in my stash for a long time, but I love these little circles. Maybe I should do this one. I love these. I think I'm gonna do this one. Let's just change it up a little, Sarah. So I'm just gonna use like this side of it and loosely stamp. So it's a little bit of a different color blue too, which I'm not sure I'm loving that I did that now. It's kind of late, too late. It's there already. Now it looks too much already. I think I messed it up. No, I didn't mess it up. All right, so that's that, stop. Little bit of black in my script stamp. This is like a really, kind of like it was a set, I think, from, it's a recollection set. I like the music notes, but let's just put some script here and there in the background, right in the middle, up there, and over here. All right. And then And I want to put some flowers. I have this flower set. I think it comes from here. Yeah, it does. This is a Kelly Panassi clear stamps. That's who it's by. I think I got this. It had to be Michaels or AC Moore or something. But that is the flowers that I use. So I am going to do these in red. Am I? Yeah, I think I am. Don't know why. I'm getting crazy. Crazy, crazy. I have a stamp block. I'm going to put this on a stamp block just because it's easier to get the whole shape. And kind of go around the edges a little bit. Listen, I'm overdoing it now. Listen, I know I am. That's what happens. It's just all so fun. I can't stop myself. All right, so I'm taking that one off and I'm gonna do like a smaller one. This one. He doesn't really stick very well to my, and it's not coming out perfect, but it is the background, so that's why I don't care. I like it. It's getting crazy now. The last thing I want to do is go back with some paint and I'm going to use this stencil, which I keep opting for the stamps, the Diane Reeveley stamps. Like, she has these leaves, and I keep doing them around the edges and painting them then. See, I did them here too. But I think I'm going to go with this. Oops. This time. I like that they're a few different sizes, and I would have rather they were shorter and going along, but I'm gonna just here and there with this light foliage green and a sponge. So it's not gonna be totally, it's still kind of backgroundy, I hope. That's what I'm hoping, all right? So I'm gonna just come in from the edges with this and just see what happens. Let's just try it. Nothing's gonna happen if it's, oops, this is a, I don't really have any dry sponges here, hold on. So let's see. This sponge is kind of hard. Let's see what it looks like. Can you tell their leaves? I don't know. I can outline them. They're getting better as I run out of paint on my sponge. I like the lighter. That looks good. I mean, I'm not hating it. Sorry, all my stuff is clanking around because I'm rocking my desk. And then I like it. I definitely like it. I'm gonna add some more right here. Yep, I like it. Just around the edge. Okay, done. Done. I think I'm done with my background. Yeah. Oh, white. Yes, I gotta add my white, you guys. I'm gonna find my little tools and I'll be right back. So here's how I do my, oh, that is not white. I grabbed the wrong thing. My white, I just use my white acrylic paint and put a little puddle down, and then I make it wetter. So I just add a little water to it and make it wider so that I can get, I just am using this, the cap to my glimmer mist. Just take the cap, and I love this part. I love to add these white, I don't know why, but I love this part. It's cool. And I do them in a different size too. So I'm gonna do one, two, and that's it. I'm gonna do them with the cap of this Faber-Castell Pitt pen. And same thing. Oh, look, I get a bubble sometimes. I like that. See, look, I did it again. The first one comes out as a, oops, I just smudged that one. Comes out as a bubble sometimes. Is that enough? I love how the white brightens it up though. Isn't that awesome? Look, and then there a little bubble came in the middle of it. That's so cool. Sorry, I'm having a little bit too much fun. And that's it. I love that. Look at that. Like, it looks like, can you see that? See, like, the spot? There's two spots. That's because a bubble gets made in here. I'm like so excited. Why didn't I like science? Because that seems like it should be scientific. So cool. All right, stop. It's too fun. All right. So now we are gonna move on to, I gotta dry those circles, but then I'm gonna glue down my butterflies, and I gotta figure out these twinkling H2Os because I've never, ever, ever used them before. I love this background. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna take a picture of this with my phone. It's just super cute. I like it. So pretty. I would like to just do a canvas with those colors and stuff. And I love that there's flowers and swirls. And then like the leaves, I could actually outline them a little, maybe with like a green jelly roll pen or something, or something a little more subtle. So I still don't, I don't think I want to outline anything besides the butterflies and maybe, I think I might put fly. That's it. Just, that's the whole sentiment. All right, so I'll be right back. I kind of don't want to cover this up, so I'm going to, but I will. I can always do it again. I'm just taking some of my matte medium. This is the fluid. I got this instead of Mod Podge to try it, and I'm liking it. It's like a glue, just a liquid glue. Creates a matte, non-reflective finish. Yeah. So anywho, and I just use these. I love these little brushes here. They're starting to get, this is just a Craft Smart, I think they are. But they're, I'm beating them up pretty good with my mediums. And they're still holding in there, so. I didn't take an allergy pill today because I'm trying to wean off them. And it, like, I swear, like, totally, I think you're addicted to them once you start taking them. I don't know. All right, where do I want to put this? I think I want to put him over here. And then I'm going to make them kind of go up into, should I do that? Something like that? No. See, now I changed it. I think I want to do that. Do I? And then I'm going to put fly over here. Because before, I always seem to be a right-hander when I put stuff on. It doesn't look like it's kind of like, what is it called? Organic, if I do that. Maybe I need another one. Maybe I should put the big guy by himself. I don't know. This is like, why is this so like daunting? Just put it down there, Sarah. I'm going to put him here. Right here. So you just take your matte medium and put it onto the surface. And because I haven't used any anything that will kind of activate with moisture or water, I'm good. But if you were to use gelatos under here or some of your Tim Holtz supplies, because his are, a lot of his reactivate with water, it might smudge and give you a problem. But I used permanent. Oh, see, he kind of, I can't, there's a bump here. Doesn't matter. I used the permanent ink, dries fast and everything. So let's see, do I want to do, I like that actually. I'm going to put the little guy over here. Ha ha ha. Shake things up a little. I have no idea. And he's like off center. Let's see what happens. And then this one over here. I didn't want them to be on the crack of the page, so I just kind of put them on each page. And I'm going to put fly down here. I don't know if I'm going to use my new stamps. Just stamp them directly onto the page. I think that's what I'm gonna do. See, I'm such a rough brusher that I actually like wrinkled up my stuff and I made his little body go this way, which I don't mind. All right, so that's it. They're on there. And I don't think I'm gonna put anything else on there. I have other butterflies that I could put. I could just put tons of butterflies, right? I mean, they're different. They're not the same type of drawing, you know, like the same style, I should say. And I'll think about it. I'll think about it. But for now, I think I'm just going to go with this. I was going to use these Tim Holtz Tall Text stamps. And put, I think, just FLY, like right down here. That's it. Yeah, I think I am. or spread your wings. Spread your wings. I could put spread your wings with my little Dymo. I like my Dymo. Oh gosh, it's on the floor. Let's see what spread your wings would look like. Just letting that matte medium dry. So I'm just gonna get rid of Create. This is in the biggest font, 24. S, and that's a capital. I'm gonna go small. P R E. Spread. Space. Let's go capital Y. And the rest small. And then capital W. Oh, you know what? I could have done it in three separate words. Yes, I want to do it in three separate words. So I'm going to print it and then cut it. And I'll show you in a minute. So let's do your, I'm not the fastest. Oh, I got to get rid of that. And I don't know how to clear it without backing up. They don't really give you very, they don't give you any directions really. Oh, wait, capital Y. O-U-R, print. It's simple. I mean, I guess that's why they don't give you very good directions, because it's pretty self-explanatory. And then go back, wings. I want to do capital W, small ings, print. And I'm using a plug because I didn't have any AAA. It takes AAA batteries, so. But that's what the letters look like. I like the font and stuff. I think you can italicize it, you can bold it. I haven't really played with it to figure out exactly what it does. I've just done what I've needed for it so far. Spread your wings. So I could just put that, spread your wings. Or just a big fly. I like spread your wings though, because butterflies have wings. Well, that's pretty obvious. I could have just done it in one, but we'll see. So that's off to the side for now. Is this dry? All right, I gotta get my twinkling H2Os, and let's see what these guys do. They're watercolors, and I know that, oh, cool. They have the names on the bottom, sea glass. Oh my gosh, oh, they're cakes. Look at that, it moved around in there. So it's a cake. I ordered these from Amazon. I'm going to use purple, yellow, blue, and pink. I wish I had orange, but for now, I think I'm just going to use purple and yellow. Purple, yellow. Could that be all I need? And then, I mean, I could always add... What should I do? Oh, you know what else? I'm gonna make their bodies this halo blue gold. Yes, 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 I am. All right, so let's just start playing. I have my little squirt bottle. And add some water in these cakes. That's what you're supposed to do, I'm pretty sure. Doesn't give you any other directions. Let's see what the box has. Nothing. Shimmering watercolors. Nothing, no directions. So I'm hoping for the best. Let me get a brush. This is like a number 2. My brushes are so old you can't even tell. I think it's a number 2 round. And let me go for this yellow. This actually is really watery right now, because I think the more pigment that gets melty, it'll make it a thicker, creamier paint, is what I think I've seen on when I've watched demos and stuff, because it is getting creamy. Like, it's definitely a cake. I'm gonna see what this looks like. Just, I think I could get it to be more opaque, but you can see that. But I think I want it to be more opaque, so I'm gonna let it. Oh, cool. It is getting, it's kind of like melting the cake the longer the water stays on there. Okay, so I've, oh yeah. Now I just got a little bit bigger brush, but I've left the water just sitting there, and now it's like really creamy. Well, I've created a little bit of a creamy puddle, shall we say. All right, that one looks good. I'm gonna mix up this purple. It's definitely creamy and sparkly, so hoping for the best. Kirby, stop! Our neighbors are building. There's a lot next door. So there's like trucks coming and going all the time. And they wake her up. She does not like it. Listen to how angry she is. All right, so I'm getting my little pen, my little brush again. I'm gonna go back into that yellow. I want to do this whole section right here. See, she's at the back door. Because they're building their house, like, really far back. Into the, like, there's woods in front of their house, and then they made a clearing. So, behind my house, you can, it looks like a construction zone. What do you think of that? Can you see it? It's very light, but I wanted to use yellow for sure. I'm gonna make that the most prominent yellow one, and then this will be just this, just going over it again and see, and then this one will be the least prominent yellow, I think. Just these little guys. I don't know. I'm just seeing how, what happens. We built our house almost, Joe and I were, say it's like 20 years ago now. Can't believe it. I was on the way to the pediatrician with my kids and came upon this street, this just random street. I never really went this way. It's gotten so built up over the years. There's a Target, a Walmart, like there's everything now. There wasn't much here back then. So I, on the way home, I just kind of ventured down around, and there were four lots left. It was a development that was already built. And there were four lots left, so we got one. It was, he wanted to build. We never ever went house shopping, which was a little disappointing, but I think he's just gonna be purple and yellow. That's it. But I love our house, so it's all good. I'm not gonna complain one bit. So yeah, because we just painted James's room, my youngest is 25, and we moved here when he was in kindergarten, so it's going this winter, because we moved in, there was a snowstorm, I remember that, and our yard wasn't finished yet, so it was like a muddy mess out there, but we moved in before the landscaping was finished. Anywho, so yeah, this lot beside us has been the last one of the four. All the other three were built, but that one just sat and sat and sat and sat and sat and sat. I think the original owner, his wife passed away, and so he never did anything with it. So he just had it forever. And that's what I've heard. And then I guess he finally sold it. And now this man, Bob, is building. And I think he's a builder. So I think his family is helping him. Like, I see it's taking forever. Like, I would, ugh. I have no patience at all. That's looking pretty. Can you see that? Definitely popping, right? But, I mean, if you have somewhere to live while you're building, that's different. We sold our house in like a week. When we sold our, we had to rent while this was being built, and it was horrible. Well, it wasn't horrible, but then timing-wise, you have to time it just so you can, it was a little bit of a, we had to stay in a hotel for like a week. I remember that. Oh my God, it was horrible. I think we got fined for putting our furniture in the garage, like some of our furniture, because we didn't have our CO yet. Oh my gosh. Anywho, that was so long ago. I can't believe it. But that is where my painting adventure began, because one of my neighbors in this neighborhood, Ellen Gannon, her name was, and she's moved to Colorado since then, but she was in the Shore Pines Decorative Artists. And her son and James were in the same kindergarten class. So, you know, she came over, we got to talking, and she saw little painted things that I had around the house. Just cheesy, probably magnets on the fridge or something. And did I like to paint? She asked. I said, well, yes. So that's what started it all. I became a member of the Shore Pines Decorative Artists, which is the local chapter of the National Society of Decorative Artists. And started taking classes, and that was it. My house slowly filled up with painted things. So that is a very prominent purple. So this one's going to be a little less prominent, and this one's going to be the least prominent. So I think I'm going to go purple on the outside edge of this one. Anywho, I could actually go away and paint these and be back, because I'm finding that they're just, if I wet my brush and go into the, what is it called? What did I call it? A cake. It gets juicy pretty fast. Like, it's creamy. And it's twinkly for sure. I ordered the silks, this one. What is it? I have one out here, this one. These are shimmering semi-gloss acrylic glazes, and I only have the gold of this, Emperor's Gold. And I've never tried it. I got this, they used to sell them in single pots like that at, I think it was Michael's, because that's where I got a lot of my stickles too. They used to just sell them individually in a bin thing, and now I think they've changed the way they do it now. But anywho, I don't think I've ever used it. But I ordered the glazes, and like I said, I have orange in there, because I definitely am still into the pink and orange. And for butterflies, they usually have a little bit of orange. Oh dear. So I'm looking forward to that. But when you order from Amazon, the products come from all different places. So some of the stuff you get, well, I have Prime, so we get it 2 days, free shipping. And that's wonderful. But then some of the things start to trickle in. So when I did my haul, it was over about a week of receiving the packages. And then, like I said, the last one to come is my silks. The Posca, the Uni Posca paint pens, which I have an idea for. I'm going to do a piece very similar to the one that Cinnamon Clooney did. It's a tree. And I think I could do that very easily with my paint pens. I'll paint the background. I'll just do the background and paint, like regular paint. Anywho, where was I? But yeah, it was weird because the fine point ones came like 4 days before the wider ones did. So I don't know where they came from. I mean, it says it on Amazon. They come from different vendors. I don't pay attention. All right, so that one, and then this one's gonna be a more like a middle. All right, and I'm gonna go away and come back with those all painted. So I'll see you in a minute. All right, they're all painted. I ended up going over, I was practicing what I was gonna say. This is my silks, and I added one squirt of water, and this is all like, this is probably what I was thinking with the twinkling. This is not, this is creamy. Sorry, I'm excited. but I think I'm going to, I'm not crazy about the yellow twinkling H2O, so I'm going to use this gold. I mean, I don't know, maybe I should stir it. Look at it. It's like, am I supposed to completely stir it? I think so, maybe. I don't know. They don't have a lot of directions. Should I add more water? Don't know. Sorry, I'm just getting my brush back because I gooped it all up. All right, so let's see. I'm just going to use this to paint where I put the yellow. I think I need more water in here. I'm going to add more water. I want it to be a little more fluid. This is weird. I've never had a paint that was like cake and then it totally dissolves like that. And it's still not to a paint consistency, I would say, and I'm trashing my brush by doing that. But listen, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just seeing. It's not paint yet. It's still goop. I'm not sure what to do. I think I'm going to put a little in the cap and get that to be the way I want it. So I'm going to add water. One more blob of water. And see if that makes it more. I think I could paint with that now. But not thrilled with that. I mean, not because it was just so confusing. Let's see how it looks. I'm going to go over, like I said, these yellow places. See, that's more paint. I can paint with that now. It was too sheer, that yellow. I kind of think this is going to be different too because I'm on top of another medium. Like I'm putting this on top of the sparkling or twinkling, I should say, H2O's. So I don't know that this is even a true representation of what you get with it. But let's have a look at that. It's popping more, but I'm still, I don't know. I think I would have preferred yellow. But see, you couldn't even see this yellow. So that's why I wanted to bump it up. What was I gonna say? So I also stamped out Spread Your Wings in one piece. I was gonna do it in three, but I think just the way this piece looks, I kinda wanted it to be in one piece. I also tried not to go over all the definition lines with the paint as much so that I don't want to outline this again. Like I don't, when I sometimes I go over with my Fude pen all the definition lines, but I'm not sure I want to do that on this one, so we'll see. I have to put the antenna on, so I'll probably go around them. But before I do that, I want to do some shading too. So I think I'm going to glue my words on right now. I'm gonna wipe this out because I don't want it to get goopy. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. We'll see how those gleams work out. But I'm gonna use the blue that I did the background with. It's this blue here. This is called turquoise blue. It's an Americana paint. And I'm gonna do my, you know, my side load technique. That's my fave, my go-to. Because I told you, I don't want to use, or I might have said this in my, when I shared my art journal pages, that I don't want to use that brown pit pen all the time, because I think it muddies all my color. I don't want to, I want to see what this looks like. So I am side loading my brush into the blue, and I'm going to like get some dark color around the butterflies, kind of. That was a lot. I had a lot of paint on my brush, guys. That was what that was. But I take a mop brush and I just kind of mop some of that color away. But do you see how it's setting the little guy into the piece? I have so much paint on my brush. Wowee. But I like it. I am a heavy hand, if you haven't heard. And that means that I never go in lightly. I got some on the wing. I'm not happy about that. I'm going to take my Q-tip. Always have a Q-tip just to kind of clear that off there. But yeah, now he's kind of into the back of the background, right? Let's have a look in a minute when I'm done this. And see the in comparison what the other butterflies look like that haven't been kind of shaded into the background. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, I'm liking it. I'm gonna do that around all the blue, actually I'm gonna put, let me get this. I want to show you something. This decal sticker, right? Spread your wings. I'm just gonna put it right here in one line. Do I want that much on the ends? Yeah, I'll leave it like that. You just bend it in half, and that's how you get the sticky back off. And it's really good adhesive. But I mentioned this before too. I don't know if it was in my haul or what. I'm gonna try and get this straight. Hopefully, because that's annoying when you don't put it straight. Straight enough, right? See how shiny that is? It's a very, very shiny. And I mean, compared to the twinkling H2Os, it's not too bad. But I am going to put, it's adhesive and it's stuck pretty good. But I am just going to take my matte medium. Like, I'm just going to put a drop of it right there. And I can actually just, I have paint all over my fingers. So I am going to grab a brush. This is the brush that I used to put the other ones down, and just go over the top of that with the matte medium. That just kind of calms it down, and it's also like a double glue. So now that's really glued down well. I'm going to change my battery and come back and show you. I'm going to finish the shading with you watching, so I'll be back. Okay, so I decided to change the background shading color to Payne's Gray. And I'm gonna show you, I mean, it's called Payne's Gray, but it's like a blue gray. And it's really dark here. You can't really tell what it looks like. I'm gonna try and go in, you know what, I'm gonna switch brushes and go to my smaller brush and see if I can not go as heavy-handed. But I'm side-loading the brush and I'm blending the color. I just want to see what this looks like. It's actually like a purpley blue, purpley black kind of thing. I don't know. I like it. We'll see what happens if I go around the hole. You definitely see it. I mean, it doesn't blend in as much as that blue. So maybe just in the darkest areas, like where the wings right here, like right here, back here. There's a little bit, his body separates from his, from the wing. I like that. I think that's what I'm going for with the brown, but just the brown just isn't the color that I want to use. Like, it's too, it dulls everything down. This doesn't seem to be dulling it the way the brown does. So I think I'm gonna stick with this. Let's see. Now let's have a look. I didn't do this little area of this wing. And I don't have nearly the amount of paint on my brush that I did when I did that blue up there. So I'm just saying, because I was afraid to add too much color. See, now I'm kind of pulling it off. I didn't mean to do that. I want this to be dark in here, so I'll come back in, but I think that's better. I think I like that better. And that's what I want to do around the butterflies. Again, I corner load my brush. I'm going to bring this in and see if you can see what I'm doing. I go into the water. I blot on my paper towel. Just take a little bit of paint on the corner of my brush and I push, there's water and paint there. It's a little too much water, so I just blot it again. But now I have, it's kind of like a gradation, I say. I don't know if that's the correct word. But it goes from darkest up against the piece. So you want your brush to be the darkest up against the wing and it bleeds out to water. And that's how you get that, like, it's not a blending, it's a transition from, so like, look, I'm putting the color, I'm gonna try and zoom in a little, guys, the corner of my brush right up in this corner, and I just keep walking it down. But the color is up against the wing and the water is out to the edge so that it's darkest up against the wing and then the water comes out. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's like it fades from paint, from darkest paint to light paint to water. That's what a float is. I'm gonna do it here. And that's what decorative painting taught me, how to use acrylics this way instead of blending techniques, wet on wet blending. This is a way that you can get that look with water, just using the paint and water to get that kind of shaded look. So you can do this on backgrounds, but you can also do it on the piece. Like, I might actually shade this butterfly, I'll show you, on the wings, but I have to pick a color that's not gonna be as dark as this. Like, I think this is a little bit too dark. Maybe a brown, but no, I think a green maybe, no, what, I don't know if I should do, am I still, yeah, I'm still zoomed in. So I just keep going back and adding paint, adding water to my brush as needed. When I feel it's dry, getting dry, I add water. When I feel like I'm running out of paint, I add more paint to my brush. But it's a process. And if you guys want to learn how to float, check out my painting tutorials because I do a lot of floating, when I paint with acrylics. And because this is mixed media and this is my art journal, I'm doing it the way I know how. And I have the pit pens, the Faber-Castell pit pens, and I love using them. They're super fun to use because we put matte medium in the background, you can just put that, it's India ink and it's permanent. And you just put that brush down and you can smudge it with your finger and you get this, the same look that I'm getting with the paint. But because I'm a painter, or I started out as a painter, I like that though. This is the technique that I'm gonna use. So I think that's accomplishing what, oops, and I'm zoomed in. That's exactly what I wanted to accomplish, and I did it with on my own terms, you know, like with my own color and okay. But I am gonna do a little bit around spread your wings, and I wanted to do this before I outline anything because that Fude pen, it will run. If I go back over that with paint, because I've finished the piece after I've put my lines on and everything, and then I've wanted to hit it with paint here and there, and I've smudged it. So that's the last step, is using that Fude rollerball pen. I'll show you. Or I could outline this now. I don't think I do. With my Uniposca paint pens, but I don't think I have a fine enough marker. I might. I might have a look and see. And I could go over that with, I kind of like the brightness of the white, but it probably needs a little color too. I think blue. The actual, this blue that I did the background with. I'm just gonna do a little right on top of here. Like a wash of color just to blend it in with the background a little more. Is that good? Good. So yeah, so now I am going to, I think, use my food. I think that's all I want to do. That's it. So like basically the page is done. This one really looks really shaded up here because I did it first with the other blue. But that could just be part of the background. So I'm not, it doesn't look bad. I think it turned out good. I'm pretty happy. I mean, the Twinkling H2Os are basically, I would say, just like the Martha Stewart pearls. I mean, that's what they kind of look like to me, is like a pearlized paint. So I mean, worth a try, and I like them. They take up less room in your stash for sure. I'm just gonna make sure the paint's all dry before I get my Fude ball rollerball, and I'll show you that in a minute. And I think that's it. I'm gonna really consider this done. You know what I've not done a lot, and that's what these the Uniposca paint pens are going to be great for. I could do like take my black now and like go around the edge and make a frame. Do I want to do that? I don't know. See, this is, I was doodling on this page earlier because I wanted to try and, I'm going to do a page with these pens. And I wanted to see, that's a pretty fine line, you guys. I think I'm going to do my outlining with this on this one. Let's just go for it. Where is the, oh well, I'm just, I think that was 10 minutes. So I'm going to make my antennas. And I'm going to go around my butterflies. I mean, it's definitely not a thin, thin line, but I like it. I definitely think it's thin enough. So this is the fine point paint pen. So this is actually paint in here. So I'm thinking when it's dry, it shouldn't smudge or anything. It's acrylic paint. It's a water-based paint. Because, and you know what? Oh shoot, I forgot to shade the butterflies. What color would I use? Maybe the Payne's gray. Not sure. Look at this. These are fantastic, you guys. OMG. These are a pleasure to use. They are amazing. The Uniposca paint pens. So look at that. Wow. I was going to go down here, and I think I will. But then I just realized, do I want to shade them? I think I could shade them, but I don't know what color to use. I'm going to use the Payne's Gray and just a very light touch and see what happens. So let's see here and down to here. I like it. I think it looks good. So I'm going to go just along his body. But look at that. Look at the difference, right? And there's a separation sometimes between the butterflies, like top wing and bottom wing. But that one had it, but this one doesn't. So I'm just going to go down the body and kind of down the... really didn't even need it down here because it's not on the body. So I'm going to try and take that off without taking everything else off. I just want to put it along the bodies. That's all I'm going to put it. I like it though. I'm glad I did it. I'm going to put it here, just along his body. And then on the other side of all the wings. But this one, see how this one has what the bottom wing, I should say, is like over, the top wing is under the bottom wing, is what I'm trying to say. So that's why I did that. And then this one, just up against the body. And it just adds a little bit more reality to it, you know? Because it would be a little more dense color there. I like it. And see, that's what happens. Like, you're just having so much fun and in the zone that like it gets away from you. You can just start to do too much is what I mean. Like I've never had a good easy time of stopping embellishing is what I'm trying to say. I keep going. All right, but I think I am going to take my paint pen and go down the sides of this. I have to kind of get right on top of it so I can see the lines. I like it. And look, I totally made a thin line with that. OMG, I am happy about these pens. Oh, he needs his antennas. They were on the stamp, but of course I cut them off. And those aren't very realistic looking. They're kind of cutesy antennas, but that's okay. Okie dokie. So did anyone watch True Detective, the second season? Joe and I did. The finale was on last night. And yeah, we were a little disappointed with the ending. I don't want to do any spoilers, but it wasn't the perfect ending. The first season with Woody Harrelson and, what's his name? Matthew McConaughey was so good. We love that one. And that had a good ending. It had a good ending. Should I go across? I think I'm just going to leave it. Like it was, you know, a happy ending. We kind of like when the characters that you've kind of come to love, you know, they make out okay at the end. It's not as fun when they don't. So, yeah, anywho. We're also huge Game of Thrones fans. See, I want to see something. I kind of went out of lines there. Look, it's acrylic paint. It's not dry. That means I can get it off before it. And you can do that with, the matte medium allows you to do that with the Fude. I'll show you that pen. This is the what I'm talking about when I say fude. I don't know if that's the official terminology. Oh, now I don't know what it is. I have others, but I was using, here it is, the Scarlet Lime pen. I think it's just like a rollerball of some type, but it writes really well on mixed media. So then I was hearing so much about this, the Fude ball pen 1.5. And this really writes well on mixed media too. It's a pigment ink made in Japan. It's water-based. So, but once it dries, it's on there. But like I said, before it's dry, you can smudge it. So, let's see what this is looking like. Pretty cool. But you can also wipe it off. Like if you went out of the lines, you can wipe it off just like I did. But this is paint. And I just like it. Oh my gosh. I'm very, very pleased with these. So you know what? I'm just going to finish this off just the way I normally do. I'm going to put the date, which is, I'm looking at my phone, August 10th already. So I'm going to go August 10, 2015. And I'm just going to make a line, like a frame, around it. And I'm really enjoying my art journal. This is so fun. Like, I don't feel like I have to do anything with this now. Like, sell it or, you know, I mean, there's a lot more I could do with it. I mean, fun-wise. But now I can just close the book and do the next one. Like, I don't feel like it's a finished piece that I have to hang on the wall or anything. Like, I could just play. This one, I don't know. What the heck? This one is pretty. I like this one. I talk funny when I'm happy. All right, you guys. So that was it. Exploring my twinkling. Oh, wow. They are definitely some shiny butterflies. Those are the twinkling H2Os. I love the background on here. And I hope you guys learned something or at least took away some good stuff from it. Look, we can still see a couple of my dragonflies in the background. If I tip it just the right way. The other two got covered up. But I like it. I think it turned out cool. All right, you guys. Thanks for watching.